chapter in the life and death of an Appalachian icon, legendary moonshiner Marvin Popcorn Sutton. 10 News reporter Jim Matheny joins us in the information center. Jim, people from all walks of life turned out today to pay tribute to Popcorn.
Yeah, they sure did, Sean. This afternoon, the family held the first public memorial service for Popcorn Sutton. Now, of course, Popcorn Sutton killed himself in March. That was just before he was scheduled to serve a sentence in federal prison for selling his famous moonshine. And recently, the family actually decided to move Popcorn's body after some vandalism at the original gravesite. And Saturday gave the public a chance to pay their respects to Popcorn. That also included Hank Williams Jr., who said he never met Popcorn, but he knew Popcorn's liquor.
Just from his talent, I knew him from his talent and reading about his story, and that's how I knew him, like everyone else knew him.
He had his public image and he had his private image, but at home, privately, he was a very loving husband. He was very good to me.
We're losing parts of our own history, and I want that history to stay alive, even if he's passed on.
Now, after the public memorial service, a horse-drawn hearse carried Popcorn's body through downtown Parrottsville before a private burial. And we'll have a lot more on today's memorial service at 11 o'clock on the Night Beat. Also, plenty of video on our website, erikusmaximus.com.